Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. So a while back, FilmRiot did this effect with blood, and I thought it was a pretty nice effect. For this video, I'll use the assets that they provide for free. If you need them, there'll be a link down in the description for the video FilmRiot did. But the point of this video is actually how to do that effect not using After Effects, but using DaVinci Resolve. So without further ado, let's get right to that video. Okay, so here we have this little clip we're going to work with, like we have here. So let's do this effect. Okay, so let's first off go up to our media pool. And here I do have the effects, and I'm just going to drag one of those down here. As a matter of fact, I'm just going to drag it in the second viewer, and I'm just going to drag down the video and not use the audio at all. So with those two on place, let's get right to the fun part. Let's highlight the two clips here and right-click, and then let's do a new Fusion clip. And now we're ready to go over to Fusion, even though we can't see what we're doing yet. It'll make sense in just a second. So here we have our Fusion page, and if I push one on the first media in, I can see that that is the picture of me. And if I push the number two, I'll see that that is the blood portion. So first off, I'm going to highlight the media in OneNote, and I'm going to push F2 or function F2 on the keyboard, and I'm just going to rename this clip to Klaus. And I'm going to do OK, and I'm going to do the exact same thing with the media two portion, and I'm going to rename this blood. And okay, so now everything is nice, but we still can't see anything because of this white background or our layer here. So the way to fix that is to select the merge node and then go into the inspector and change the apply mode to multiply. And now it's there, as you see, and it's still way too big considering what we're going to do, but we will worry about that later on. So let's go to the next thing. Push Control Spacebar and type in Planar Tracker, and we're going to add that to my Klaus clip. And we are going to look at the track, and that's fine. We're going to change the to hyperpoint area and the perspective. I think we are going to change that into translation, and the output for the background and the luma, we're not going to change anything about that. So we're just going to do some kind of a shape. In this case, I'm just doing a shape on my t-shirt, and I am going to push in start tracking from the beginning of the timeline, and then I'm just going to track forward by pushing right here. And it just does a pretty good job at that, actually. So with all that tracked, let's continue. So we're going to push here, and we're going to create a planar transform. That's right here. I'm going to push down shift and drag that in between the blot and the merge node here. So now I just have copy pasted all of those keyframes into my blot. But this is the problem. The blot is now way too big. But we're going to change that, of course. So with the planar tracker selected, we're going to again push Control Spacebar and type in transform. And we're going to add in a transform node. And we have it right here. And now we can change the things. We can just start by dragging it and pushing it where we want it. And you can see that is really way too big and not what we want. So we're going to size this quite a bit down. Like so, maybe a little more actually, something like that. And then we're just going to position it where we think it will be nice to get a shot from a gun. Like something like that. And that looks pretty well, I think. So we can, of course, go into the merge node as well. If we want to blend in our thing, we can go into the blend option in the inspector with the merge node selected, and we can just make this to our liking. So for now, we'll just keep it at that, I think. And here we have the final product. So there we have it. If you're not satisfied with the blood type, of course, we can change that very easily. So if we go down to our clip again here, and we're going to our fusion, it's pretty simple because all of the tracking is already done. So let's take another blood type. We're just going to drag that into fusion, going to disconnect the blood we did before and just reconnect that into the planar tracker. And now that's all dandy. And if we want to change anything with the blood, it's also possible to do that either in the transform or the merge node, but we'll do it in the transform for this. We can change the aspect, but I'm not going to do that for this. I'm just going to push the aspect to reset that, and I'm just going to play around with the angle. So that's the nice thing with fusion. So there we have another type of blood once of a sudden coming in. Anyway, I do hope you found this video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button. Give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it will help them out. And if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.